like a new bed sheet. Oh, now, Switchblade Sister, lives are changing. Now it's true, come on now, whatever happened. Switchblade Sister, all right now, Switchblade Sister. You said she loved me. We'll be right back.
Christy Foxy and we're from Hollywood, California. And we are going to continue with another song that some of you know. Hit it, Miss Brian.
Bye.
Fucking this Jerry Finelli on the keyboard. Let's hear it for her. She's a super freak. She's the kind of girl you read about in New Wave magazines, believe me, I know. This you've been rooting through the used record bin, I see. This is another used classic. I looked at my face this morning. I just couldn't comb my hair. Didn't want to leave. song is entitled Peach Kelli Pop. I need to wipe off my guitar. Please hold for one moment. Please hold. Just get some music for this whole portion. This next song is dedicated to Nikki Thomas. The 1-800 girl from Sub Pop, and she helped us to decide to do this song because we're all influenced by the lady in the front row. And it's from our new album, Phase Shifter. I think you'll like it, it's really good.
Just
So this is a song where it's really slow, so you can sit here and, like us, we'll bake in our own juices.
When there's things to do, not because you gotta. When you're up for love, not because you oughta. When you trust your friends with no reason, nada, that your app name shall not be tamed. And that summer feeling is gonna haunt you one day in the sky. Summer feeling. When the cool of the palm makes you drop down on it, and the smell of the love makes you glop down on it, when the teenage cars get the cops down on it. Time is here for one more year, and that summer feeling is gonna haunt you one day in life. Oh no, one day in your life. You've forgotten what I'm naming. You're gonna long to reclaim it one day. Cause that summer feeling is gonna haunt you one day in your life. Summer feeling. And if you wait until you're older, a sad resentment will smolder one day. Summer feeling is gonna haunt you, and that summer feeling is gonna taunt you. And that summer feeling is gonna hurt you one day in your life. One day in your life. When even fourth grade starts looking good, would you hate it? And first grade's looking good too. And you pause on for that girl, would you hate it? Do you long for her or the way you were? And that summer feeling is gonna haunt you one day in your life. Oh no.
It's gonna taunt you. It's gonna haunt you. It's gonna taunt you.
Yeah.
we haven't been home for a long time. We've been all over the world, and one thing we have learned, 2,500 Red Cross fans can't be wrong. It's a tight-knit bunch with a universal language.
We're the coolest, aren't we?
And this piece, number, is entitled Any Hour, Every Day. Or Any Every Day, Any Hour.
Makeup, Jeff, stop it. You're fucking uncool. What is this, Lollapalooza?
All right.
Yeah.
guys sure you're not too hot to deal with another song? I guess I can't complain. Alright. We were just in Canada. In Canada, we would say of this of you people tonight, they'd say, alright, the mighty Seattle! Fucking mighty! You're pissed! What do you want to do, kids? Disco ball, because his next song is written by the disco queen of the 90s, PJ Harvey. System. So damn glamorous.
What song y'all wanna hear?
Oh, I love that song.
But I want... You know what? I guess we'll have to play that.
What's that? Oh, we can... Oh, yeah. We can.
I can't possibly be expected to plug my own guitar in. Fuck, man.
All these years, and you still have to plug your guitar in? Dude.
Okay, wait a minute. Don't start yet, Eddie.
Okay.
Since we're an oldies group with a new album, we're probably the only, and think about it though, you really gotta think about this, we're probably the only vital oldies group in America. Anyway, okay, since we get to this encore moment, hey Larry, will you deal with my box? It's unplugged. I really have to talk to the kids. Okay, well, since there's usually, you know, like a lot of requests at the end of the evening, and we can't possibly play them all, we don't know them all, but we want to oblige whenever possible because it's always fun, and we all have a good time, especially when it's hot, especially when we're basing in our own juices. So tonight, we're going to take 5 requests from you. Okay, for Steve, okay, wait, if you had your fantasy song for Steve, what song would it be? Wait, one at a time. Okay, this man here, Clark's girl, Steve McDonald. And okay, wait, quiet down for a second. For Eddie, if you had your choice to hear any song Eddie play, what would it be? Okay, Bad Motor Scooter, Eddie. Okay. For Jerry, if you had a choice to hear any song, what would it be? Okay, Love Lies Bleeding for Jerry. Okay, I heard Linda Blair, we're gonna assign that one to Brian.
You sing Annie's Gone.
Well, I'll sing Annie's Gone and he'll do Neurotica. I can't do Annie's Gone because I don't play on the
part. Are you singing?
No, I don't play on the
part. You're just going to sing?
No. You don't understand the concept here.
So. Oh, I'm sorry.
What? No, I got the aesthetic in the part. Ready? One, two, three. finally, we wrote a hit single. Always a Seattle favorite. Charity sing lead on this obscure British B-side.
Hello. I would like to sing you all a very sweet, heartfelt ditty. And this song is called Disco Bitch.
Thank you.
time mean you had some words. You and that mall perm you got going, it's kind of grown out, so it's getting a little flat on top. I dare say you need another trip to the hairdressers to have your roots done. That blonde job isn't fooling anybody. Only your hairdresser knows for sure, my ass. And you've been in that tanning salon way too long, honey. You are the color of a Cheetos, with no visible tan lines whatsoever. Now let's talk about your fashion sense. I don't know where you thought that white cowboy boots with the fringe at the side were gonna cut it, but they ain't cutting it. They're out of here. You're wearing those skin-tight, acid-wash, stone-wash Levi's so tight that you gotta lay on your back to zip them up. Not that laying on your back is too much of a stretch for you. And speaking of tight jeans, those jeans are so tight that I can see in your back pocket the outline of a little file of blow, which you're like trotting off to the bathroom to do a toot before you're off on your way, buzzing off in your Z28 IROC Camaro, early 80s model, not even a good year. You're on your way to some god-awful Billy Ray Cyrus, achy breaky, two-stepping, corn-fed, country hellhole of denim and diamonds to go pick up the church porch and all that hell. You're off to pick yourself up a Joey Buttafuoco look-alike wearing neon balloon pants. Okay, now let's talk about your decor. I happen to know that in your bedroom there hangs a framed Nagel print. Okay, like you know that kind of Duran Duran Rio album cover, Hungry Like a Wolf. You got one of those framed. You got one of those framed behind glass. Framed behind glass. Like the deserving work of art that it is. Honey, let me say something. Early 80s? Honey, 80s? You are so 80s. I'd say you're about somewhere in that realm of 82 to 84. Somewhere right around there. That was not a pretty sight, if I recall. And I recall it a little too well, maybe. the truth
Jerry,
is...
really, what do you have against Disco Bitch? And what has she ever done to you?
That bitch.
And why, and let's have...
Because of that bitch, I, you know?
Why don't your boyfriend fuck her?
Yeah. Come on, answer that one.
Blame the victim. Blaming the victim. Hey.
Yeah, you can't play the victim anymore. This is the 90s, chick. Get hip!
Well, this is my little revenge. Disco Bitch is my little revenge. This is, you know, allow me my moment in the sun, okay? Don't rain on my parade. Disco bitch! Disco bitch!